Paint Bar channel. My name is Jackie and I have a really special guest today. Her name is
Juliet.
Juliet, and Juliet is here with us today because she entered one of our contests on how to paint a trick-or-treat pattern. She gave us the cutest idea. Ta-da! So we're going to be painting this with you today, guiding you step by step and telling you everything so you all have a beautiful trick-or-treat bag to take with you for Halloween. So come along with us. We're so excited to paint with you. Let's get painting. Before we begin, let's go over a few of the materials that we need. Number one is we need a plate. You can use any colors you want for your own bag, but we decided that we're gonna use white, blue, green, yellow, red, purple. We actually call it unicorn poop. And black. We have 5 brushes to go over. Actually, you won't need all 5 at home. These are the 5 that we used at the paint bar. We're probably only gonna use 3 today. Number one is?
Big brush.
Yes, number one is the big brush. It's really good for covering the whole background. Number 2.
Round brush.
This is the round brush. Exactly, it's rounded all the way around and it comes together on top. And then last but not least is the cutest brush of all.
Baby brush.
This is your baby brush. This is the one that bedazzles our painting and pulls it all together. Today, we are using a tote bag. These are special bags brought to you by the paint bar. But at home, you can get one that's just a canvas tote bag that you can use for trick-or-treating. We also have a cup of water. And then last thing is our paper towel. Here, let me fan you off. These are great for fanning off the person you're painting with or for using them to wipe your brushes off. The first brush we're gonna use today is the biggest brush of all. It's the big brush. Now, every time you use a new brush, you always wanna give your brush a little dunk into your water. Wipe it off. You can wipe it on that paper towel, which we have here. We're gonna start off by painting your background using blue. We wanna make like a dark scene in the back. So you can use some blue, you can add a little bit of white, you can use some of your purple color. So to begin, we're gonna start off by taking our big brush, and we're gonna take a nice big scoop of our blue. I'm also gonna take a little bit of the purple, and maybe even some white. We're gonna start off by painting the whole background. The more paint you use, the easier it'll be to spread around. Brush again, dip into your white, and we're gonna go to the upper right hand corner. corner, and we're just gonna make a circle that should be smaller than the size of your moon.
Add a yellow little line to here.
She added some little yellow lines. What's that gonna do for your moon?
Make it bright.
Alright, now take a baby brush, give it a dump in your water, tap it off. We're gonna start off by adding some grass. So to make the grass, you're gonna use some green and you're gonna use some yellow. We're also gonna use some white. Is you're going to go onto your canvas and you're going to make brush strokes kind of flicking upwards, okay? Like this. I'm taking my brush and I'm just flicking the brush upwards like this next to each other, and I'm letting all of the colors blend. Now when it comes time to come near your pumpkin, you can actually have it overlap your pumpkin just a little bit. We already made that, right? Can you remind everybody how we made the round?
Yellow, green, and red.
Right, and if you have a hard time remembering how to make those colors, she has a great way to remember.
The stoplight colors.
Yeah, just mix all the stoplight colors together. So I'll do it again for you. I just want this to be a little bit lighter than the other brown we used for the tree. So we're gonna add a tiny bit of the white. Ooh, I like that kind of brown. I might even add some of that to my tree. Make like a little wobbly line like that. From the top, you're gonna loop over. It should be thin on the top and a little bit wider towards the bottom.
You're just so cute.
All right, so now we're gonna clean this brush off. So now it's dipped in the black. We're gonna start off by making two triangles for the eyes. Ready? One. Then we're gonna make a U shape for the bottom of the mouth. All right, then if you have space, you can make little triangles. Clean the brush off. Now it's time to make our crown. To make the crown, we're gonna dip into your
yellow first.
Okay. Now I'm just gonna suggest we add a little bit of the white to the yellow, otherwise it won't show up on the blue background. On the left, upper left side of the pumpkin, we're gonna make a line like that. And then I'm gonna give mine some triangles. Fill them in. All right, so clean your brush off. So now we're gonna bedazzle our crowns by adding little jewels on the top of your crown as well as along the bottom. So we're gonna use some red and white, and red and white together makes
pink.
Pink. We're gonna put little dots right on top. And we're gonna make little dots along the bottom. Start off by adding white everywhere. It's a great way to make your painting really pop. And I'm gonna start by putting little dashes of white into my grass. I'm gonna add some white into my pumpkin. You don't need to have them all over the pumpkin, just a little bit. You can also make little eyeballs. What was the name of your pumpkin again?
Pumpkin.
All right, last step. We're gonna do the stars. So you're gonna use your brush, dip the back of the brush into your paint, and then like a stamp, you stamp down little stars. Now a really great idea that you could do is you could use glow-in-the-dark paint, which we don't have today, but if you bought glow-in-the-dark paint, these would glow, which would be cool.
Making the North Star right there.
Dun-da-da! Thank you so much for joining us today. We hope you had as much fun painting as we did. If you enjoyed this video, we would love you to subscribe to our channel, like this video, comment below, and let us know. know what you want us to paint next, right? Give us a little thumbs up. And we want to see your artsy pics. So if you painted along with us today, make sure that you post it using the hashtag TPBArtsy so we can see your gorgeous work, and tag it at the paint bar using the hashtags, which are listed down below. Thank you so much for joining us today. It was great painting with you and we hope to see you all again soon.